My name is Jhansi Lakshmi. I am working as assistant professor in SMU department as a mathematics faculty. The college is located in Hyderabad. I am going to explain beta gamma functions. that is beta mn is equal to, we can take 2 into integral 0 to pi by 2 sine to the power of 2m minus 1 theta cos to the power of 2m minus 1 theta d theta. One more property of beta function, we can write beta mn is equal to 2 into integral 0 to pi by 2 sin to the power of 2m minus 1 theta cos to the power of 2m minus 1 theta d theta. So every property will prove from the beta definition only. This is the definition of beta function. Let here x is equal to sin square theta. X is equal to sin square theta. So 1 minus x is equal to, x is equal to sin square theta. 1 minus x is equal to 1 minus sin square theta, which is nothing but cos square theta. 1 minus x is equal to cos square theta, x is equal to sin square theta here. So we need to find here what is dx. Dx is equal to differentiating on both sides. X differentiation is dx. Sin square theta differentiation is 2 sin theta. Sin theta differentiation is cos theta. Theta differentiation is d theta. So we have dx is equal to 2 sin theta cos theta d theta. And we have to find the limits of theta here. According to the definition, limits of x is 0 to 1. So we need to find the theta limits here. Let lower limit of x is equal to 0. If x is equal to 0, sin square theta is equal to 0. Sin square theta is equal to 0 means when the sine value is 0, if theta is equal to 0 degrees or 0 radians. We need to find the upper limit of theta here. We have the lower limit of theta is 0. Upper limit of theta means we need to take the upper limit of x. According to the definition of beta function, the x upper limit is 1. Means x is equal to sin square theta. X is equal to 1, that is sin square theta is equal to 1. When the sin value is 1, sin square theta is 1 means sin theta is 1. From the theta is equal to pi by 2 radians. Theta is equal to pi by 2 radians. That means for the theta we have the limits 0 to pi by 2. 0 to pi by 2. By the definition of beta function, we have to take x is equal to substitution sin square theta. 1 minus x is equal to cos square theta. Shall we substitute in the definition to prove this property? Substituting here, all this theta is equal to 0 to pi by 2, which limits we have from the substitution of x limits 0 to pi by 2 and x to the power of m minus 1. What is our x here? Sin square theta to the power of m minus 1. We have 1 minus x is equal to cos square theta. Substituting here cos square theta to the power of m minus 1. And dx is also we have in terms of theta. That is 2 sin theta cos theta d theta. Substituting here that 2 sin theta cos theta d theta. All substituted in terms of theta. So simplifying this, we know the 2 is constant taking outside, which is nothing but theta is equal to 0 to pi by 2. All sine powers we can add here. Sine power of here 2m minus 1. 2m minus 1. Sorry, 2m minus 2. This is 2m minus 2 into here sine power 1 is there. So powers are adding plus 1 of theta. And similarly cos powers are adding here. Cos to the power of 2m minus 2. Here power 1 is there plus 1 theta d theta, which is equal to 2 into integral 0 to pi by 2 sin to the power of 2m minus 1 theta cos to the power of 2m minus 1 theta d theta. This is second property of beta gamma beta function here. Okay. Shall we prove the third property, that is beta mn is equal to beta m plus 1 comma n plus beta n comma n plus 1. Okay, we have one more property that is in beta gamma functions. Beta mn is equal to beta m plus 1 comma n plus beta n comma n plus 1. This is also we have to prove by the based on the beta function definition. We have the beta definition is beta mn is equal to integral 0 to 1 x to the power of m minus 1. 1 minus x to the power of n minus 1 dx. Shall we take first here? We'll prove this is from RHS to LHS. For that I am taking here beta of m plus 1 comma n is equal to by the definition of beta function, x is equal to 0 to 1, x to the power of m minus 1. But in the place of m, we have here m plus 1. That means m plus 1 minus 1. M plus 1 minus 1. And 1 minus x to the power of, then as it is taken here, n minus 1 dx, which is equal to integral 0 to 1, x to the power of m, 1 minus x to the power of n minus 1 dx. So, we take this is equation number 1. Next, we will take beta of m comma n plus 1 is equal to beta of m comma n plus 1 is equal to integral 0 to 1, x to the power of, instead of m, we have m only, so writing as it is m minus 1, and 1 minus x to the power of, instead of m, we have n plus 1 here, therefore n plus 1 minus 1 dx, which is equal to integral 0 to 1, x to the power of m minus 1 into 1 minus x to the power of m, which dx, which we are taking as equation number 2. Here, beta m plus 1 comma n plus beta m comma n plus 1. To get this, we have to add these two equations. I am adding here these two equations. Then we will get here beta m plus 1 comma n plus beta m comma n plus 1. These two I am adding here. So this equation plus this equation we have to take here. First equation is integral 0 to 1 x to the power of m 1 minus x to the power of n minus 1 dx plus integral 0 to 1 x to the power of m minus 1 1 minus x to the power of m dx. Adding these two, we know both are integral 0 to 1, integral 0 to 1. So I am taking integral 0 to 1. Here we have x to the power of m, here we have x to the power of m minus 1. From these two, I am taking x least power as common, that is x to the power of m minus 1 as common. And here 1 minus x to the power of n minus 1, here 1 minus x to the power of n we have. From these two, I want to take 1 minus x to the power of n minus 1 common. From here, we observe here, we know that x to the power of m, x to the power of m minus 1 means, from here x to the power of m minus 1 common means, one more x power 1 is remaining. And complete this term is common here. So, over the first term. Come to the second term, x to the power of m minus 1 is common completely. So, nothing x here. And the remaining 1 minus x to the power of, from n, I took the n minus 1 as common. The remaining is 1 minus x dx, which is nothing but x minus x gets cancelled, which into 1 dx, which is nothing but here, after cancelling x and minus x, we have only 1, which is nothing but integral 0 to 1, x to the power of m minus 1, 1 minus x to the power of m minus 1 into dx, which is nothing but according to the definition of beta function, beta m comma m. This is a proof beta mn is equal to beta m plus 1 comma n plus beta m comma n plus 1. And next gamma definition, gamma function definition, beta and gamma, these are the beta functions. And gamma function definition, non-negative integer n, for this we will take the definite integral, integral 0 to infinity e to the power of minus x, x to the power of n minus 1 dx as a gamma function. The definition of gamma function is definite integral, integral 0 to infinity e to the power of minus x, x to the power of n minus 1 dx. Here for all n is greater than 0, which is called the gamma function definition, which is denoted by the Greek letter gamma n. Gamma function is also called the Eulerian integral of second kind. Beta function is called the Eulerian integral of first kind. We have the gamma function properties also. Like for example, the first property is gamma 1 is equal to 1. We can prove by taking the definition of this. Here n is equal to 1. That means this is nothing but gamma n by the definition. Gamma n is equal to this one. Suppose to find the gamma 1 is equal to 1, we can substitute n is equal to 1 in definition of gamma function. Definition of gamma function. That that gamma 1 is equal to 1. For example, I am making the substitution of n is equal to 1 here. Gamma 1 is equal to integral 0 to infinity e to the power of minus x. Here x to the power of 1 minus 1. X to the power of 0. Anything to the power of 0 is equal to 1 into dx, which is nothing but which is equal to dx. We know that integration of e to the power of minus x is minus e power minus x. Minus e power minus x. The limits are 0 to infinity. By substituting upper limit, the value becomes 0 and substitution of lower limit becomes 1. That means minus of 0 minus 1, which is nothing but 1. So therefore, we have the first property of gamma function is gamma 1 is equal to 1. Therefore, this is the proof for the gamma function. Thank you.